Draper has led the league in faceoff wins in these playoffs. Off the tie-up, he nudged it to Rafalski. Rafalski clipped one and skidded out to center, and Malkin has it. 38 to go. It's laid along and punched back in by Hossa. Turning his balloon and clipped one that's grabbed and held by Osgood.
Draper uses that free hand pretty well. Izzo on the faceoff, but it's quick transition. I love what Crosby does here. He gets the puck and just chips it quickly so Pittsburgh can get access. Ryan Malone driving hard to the net, just puts it on goal. Eat up some time, yes, but create a stabilized situation for a faceoff. But you got to watch Draper's free hand. He's leaning down low, and if he doesn't win the try, he just takes his hands and throws the puck back.
A clean win by Draper, but still up for grabs. Zetterberg sealed up. They're all reaching in, and Crosby tried to pump it free. Got it on the stall. Delay's got a little room. It's left behind, all by Lindstrom. Moving in is Gonchar, 20 to go. Malone's pass is caught by Datsyuk. He's got some room to step out with it now. Able to get away from the reach, couples down to the ice. Play continues, Gonchar. 10 seconds to go. Gonchar flipped one. It's off the glove of Lindstrom. Sent back out to center ice off Cleary. Gonchar turns it around. It is brought right back in. A little pass to the front backhander. Celebrate at one end, the Penguins disconsolate, but their fans chanting the Let's Go Pens. They will not have another game until fall, but what a gallant finish for this one.
Well, Pavel Datsyuk had the puck in the neutral zone. He was taken down. The Red Wings thought there should have been a penalty, but the Penguins keep coming. The shot by Crosby, the glove save. Watch Marian Hossa takes a last desperate opportunity that goes over the top of the glove of Chris Osgood. Just as the clock is expiring, desperation, never give up. Watch Hossa, one hand on a stick.
Also, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the ice for the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 2008 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player.
Let's first congratulate the Detroit Red Wings and the Pittsburgh Penguins on great seasons and a terrific Stanley Cup Final. The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy is Henrik Zetterberg.
This is the trophy that the Penguins fans dreamed of, and they are respectfully watching, standing, many of them applauding as it is carried out to be presented to the opposition.
It takes two great teams to compete for this marvelous trophy. Detroit, you've had a marvelous year, and this was well-earned. Congratulations to Mike and Marion Ilitch, Jimmy DeMilano, Ken Holland, Mike Babcock, and the rest of the coaching staff, and most importantly, the players of the Detroit Red Wings. Nicholas Lidstrom, come get the Stanley Cup. It's yours to take back to Hockey Town.
This one he can touch.
It's the only one you want to touch. Now comes the tradition of the handoff. Who will get the Stanley Cup handed to them by the captain first? Sometimes it's a veteran. Sometimes it's someone who's never won it before.
Dallas Drake. 16 years, Doc. Started off as a Detroit Red Wing, the Winnipeg Jets, the Phoenix Coyotes, the St. Louis Blues, and back home for Dallas Drake, 1,009 NHL regular season games. Congratulations.
Dan Cleary, the first to ever come from the charming part of Canada called Newfoundland. Others have come close. Dan Cleary is the first to hold it over his head. Then Chris Chelios. Third time for him. Second with Detroit.
Didn't play a game in the Stanley Cup final. Waiting for an opportunity.
Notice how many of the Penguins fans are remaining to see this. Mike Babcock, the coach of the Red Wings, as it is handed off to Thomas Holmstrom. In 2003, his Anaheim Mighty Ducks lost to the New Jersey Devils. He went, spoke to his team, came back out to watch the Devils do what the Red Wings are doing right now. He said, I wanted to see it, to take it in, so that I could understand and appreciate it if I ever got there. He has. That's Chris Draper.
Don't realize how hard it is to win until you actually attain it. All the training in the summertime, the training camp, the preseason games, the regular season games, all the times away from your family, this is what it's all about. The Stanley Cup.
Chris Osgood, outstanding to the last second and a half. And then he got terrific.
Wasn't even a starting goaltender at the start of the playoffs.
Pierre and Mike Babcock.
All the bus rides, all the time in the minors, all worth it now?
It's been a ride all along the way, though. It's not like, you know, you set out to do this. You just set out to be a coach. And real fortunate here in Detroit, obviously, to have some of the best players in the world, if not the best leader maybe in hockey, and Nick Lidstrom and then the group around him. So I'm just proud to be the coach of the Red Wings, and it's great success.
You guys were resilient all playoff long. People at home want to know, what's your motivational tool to bring your guys to another level in game sixes of this playoff year?
Well, you know, it's just because we felt we probably let ourselves down in game five, and we responded. We got a real good group, and they're professional, and it's amazing the atmosphere around our team. It's a lot of fun. They work real hard, and we believe if you do those things, your skill comes out.
Mike, congratulations. You're a professional coach, and I know about all the bus rides. Way to go, Michael.
Thank you, man.
Congratulations. Mike Babcock, a Stanley Cup winner for the first time, Doc and Edzo.
It was written 20 years ago by Steve Summers of the Harrisburg Patriot News, and it sums up the feelings that we have as we watch this. The episodes in life that last so many years in memory are often measured in fleeting minutes as they happen. The horn sounded within 10 minutes ago. This time is going to go very fast, as you see Scotty Bowman, who's been a part of a lot of these, watching and smiling and laughing with some of the players that he treasured even when he was the coach of the Red Wings. Thomas Holmstrom. He is, he got close to the crease. Did you notice? He's at the hash marks now. He was
we
there.
We don't see any referees,
again.
Do we?
No, he was there again. They will all have, as the custom established in 1995 by the New Jersey Devils, a time of their own with the Stanley Cup. They were the first to actually carve the time out. We want to hear from the goaltender. Pierre has Chris Osgood.
So, the playoffs start and you're sitting on the bench. Now you're the starting goalie of your second Stanley Cup winning team as a starter. How did that happen?
Just hard work, perseverance. I just never give up. I think I have a bigger heart than people think, and I'm immensely strong. I just never give up. I'll fight right till I'm done playing my last game in this league. And I was just, we fought right to the bitter end again tonight. Took the last 3 seconds of the game, whacked the puck away, but what a win for us.